Know that you are worthy and that you are deserving of friendships that are truly fulfilling, people that truly understand you and get you, and you guys have like a deep relationship. Hey guys, what's up? What's going on? My name is Sabrina and welcome to my channel. Today, I feel very inspired to create a part two to my first video of how to step away from friendships you have outgrown. And in this video, I want to really get into the depth of how to create those new relationships, those new friendships that really align with what you desire. So with that being said, if you like this video, don't forget to hit that red subscribe button below. Feel free to hit that big thumbs up button and follow me on Instagram for more tips and inspiration on everything positive mindset, law of attraction, and spirituality related. And without further ado, let's get into this video. Now, so many of you guys are so hesitant to step away from these friendships that don't serve you. You know you need to do it. Your intuition is telling you that it needs to be done, but you're fearful. You're afraid of like, okay, many things. Of what are they gonna say? I don't want them to feel bad. Of what if I can't attract these new friends into my life? What if I'm friendless forever? You know, what if I never get friends again? Those kinds of fears and thoughts come up in our head. And so we get really hesitant and we hold on to these relationships and these friendships that don't serve us. But this isn't serving us in any way to be holding on to these relationships because our intuition is telling us to walk away from them for a reason. And a lot of times it's because our vibration is raising at a higher frequency. So these other things are falling away from our lives and we are expanding at such a rate to where we are attracting things that encourage our expansion. Okay. So say that we are expanding like this. Okay. We're expanding like this. And when you hold on to these friendships that don't serve us, we kind of go like this and like stay stagnant. Like we are like holding ourselves back from expanding to our true potential and to where we could be if we let go of these things, right? If we let go of these things that don't serve us. And this goes for everything, but in relationships specifically, in friendships specifically, we need to be comfortable with letting go of these friendships that don't serve us because that is what is best for us and our expansion. And also it's really important to know that you cannot attract your new friendships, these new things into your life without releasing the old. There is only so much space in your container. So it's like comparing it to like a significant other situation, you can't attract, if you're in an unfulfilling relationship, you cannot attract your soulmate without leaving that relationship. There just is not space for it. And the same goes for friendships. You cannot attract the friendships you desire if you still are holding on to these friendships that don't serve you. And you know, we can want to hold on to these friendships just for comfort reasons until we find the new friends we want that we really align with, but that isn't serving anyone in that situation. So what we want to do is when our intuition tells us, when we get that knowing that we need to step away, I want you to do it. I want you to have that tough conversation. It's not going to be easy. It's not going to be fun, but it is what it is. We got to do what we got to do. So when we step away from those friendships, we then step into the void, okay? The void where we don't know what's gonna happen next. We don't know who we're going to attract. We don't know how it's going to happen. And in this part, our ego gets very fearful and we can have all of these worried thoughts. The same things that I was saying before, we're gonna be friendless forever. We're never gonna be able to attract the type of people that we want in our lives. And what did we just do? And like, did I just mess up? And all of these fearful thoughts can come into our mind and all these worries. And it's because our ego is uncomfortable. Our ego is afraid of what's going to be happening next. And so whenever you get the fearful thought or these worried thoughts, become aware of it and then immediately have like some sort of trusting thought accompanied with like a trusting like emotion of like a gratitude emotion. So for example, say that you have a thought of like,
what did I just do? I'm never gonna find friends again.
Immediately stop yourself, take a deep breath, and then think, everything happens for a reason. My intuition told me to do this. And so my aligned friendships are here waiting for me. And something like that to kind of like just calm your nerves and get yourself centered and get yourself back to trusting that, like, yeah, there was a reason that you felt the need to step away from these friendships. There was a reason behind that. Really start to trust your intuition, trust your gut, trust yourself. And also in this void, when you feel lonely and stuff, become your best friend, become your own best friend. You know, crack jokes with yourself and go on a lunch date with yourself and do all the things that you would want to do with your best friend and talk to yourself, like give yourself pep talks and stuff. Really just be your own best friend. And this is such a great energy to be in because we are really exemplifying the things that we want, the energy we want to create and have and attract in our lives. In this time, I also want you to, okay, you know how when you are like attracting a soulmate, I don't know if you've heard this before, but you know how you can like make a list of all the characteristics you want to find in your soulmate, what they want to, like what you want them to physically look like, the personality traits, all that kind of stuff. And you can do that to help attract your soulmate. You can do that to attract your friendships. So write down the characteristics you want your friends to have, what kind of things you want to have in common, the values that they have, the beliefs they have, you know, and really start to visualize that and just entertain the thoughts and ideas of having friends like that and really start to like enjoy those thoughts. And that really helps you set the tone and open your container to open to receive these things because, okay, so our ego can get very fearful, right? And a lot of times we can attract very similar friendships into our lives. They may be different people, totally different people, but very similar frequencies that they are on as the old friends. And this is because our ego is so comfortable with that. And so if we're fearful of like not being able to find friends again, if we're worried about that kind of thing, a lot of times we can kind of almost like latch on to any kind of new friendship that we see, right? It's like the girl that always wants to be in a relationship and will just like find a new boyfriend and be like, oh, yep, he's mine, without even like checking like the standards that she wants to have in a guy, right? So we want to make sure we are checking our standards. That's what this list is like super great for, because if we find friends and they don't have the values that we want in a friend, if they don't have the standards and the beliefs that we want, that we fully resonate with, they aren't going to be fulfilling friendships. And so we want to make sure that we set our standards so that we don't accept things that aren't for us. And also when we do accept things that aren't for us, we're telling the universe like, I'm not ready for this expansion. And so, you know, we wanna make sure that we are doing the best we can to attract those ideal friendships into our lives, because we did not walk away from those old friendships and go through those tough conversations and do all of that. That was not fun to attract friendships that are very similar, okay? So set your standards high, know what you want in friendships, know what you want to have, the experiences you want to have, how you want to feel, all that kind of stuff, and don't settle. Also, somebody commented on that last video of part one saying that, you know, it's hard for adults to find relationships. And I totally get that. But also know that that is just a belief, okay? And our lives are created from our beliefs. Entirely. Our beliefs literally create our lives. And if we change our beliefs, we can change the experiences in our lives. So what we want to do, if that is a belief of yours, is sit down and think, okay, is this really true? Do you know adults that have friends? Do you know adults that make new friends? Like, can you find a way to kind of break down that belief? Because everything is a belief system. And if we can change our beliefs in our favor, we can create a much more desired reality for ourselves. So if that's something that you're struggling with, look at that belief and sit down and journal on it and really like start to break that down and realize that there are people all over the place. There are so many adults looking for other adult friendships and relationships. There are so many, you know, older people that quote unquote, like it's hard to find friends at this age. It doesn't have to. So if that is something that you are worried about, that is something that you should work on, Yeah, keep that in mind and do that kind of inner work. Because know that you are worthy and that you are deserving of friendships that are truly fulfilling, people that truly understand you and get you, and you guys have like a deep relationship. Don't settle. Know that magic happens in the void. When you trust your intuition, really trust your intuition, step into the void, magic happens, baby. Magic happens. So really trust that. Really know that. Really get excited because you're expanding and you have so many more experiences to have, you know, and the same people aren't necessarily meant to stay in our lives our entire lives. There are many people that are meant to be in our lives for a short period of time. So when you start to accept that and start to really like get comfortable with that, it's a lot easier to step away from those old friendships and step into the void and just really trust that this is all working out for you. Okay, so that is it that I have for today on this specific topic. I am thinking about making a part 3, so let me know if you do want me to make a part 3 about how to deal with the guilt of stepping away from friendships, because it can feel very hard and it can feel very like heavy, and that, you know, it's kind of your fault that you're making people like feel bad, right? And you don't want to make your friends feel rejected. So yeah, let me know if you want that. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you got any value out of it, make sure that you hit that big thumbs up button. Feel free to subscribe to me and leave any comment below with any questions or concerns. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.